Yes, I'm Sophie Barthes, the director of Madame Bovary. Well, I'm very happy to be part of BFI because my first film was here, but I had just given birth, so I missed the whole festival last time. So this time it's really fantastic to be here, and I think this movie is connecting really well with the British audiences, so I'm extremely happy. Well, Madame Bovary is about a young woman who comes out of the convent and marries a country doctor, and she's dissatisfied with her marriage and starts spending and eventually takes lovers and self-destructs. So the reason I wanted to make it as a film today, I think there is a lot of themes that are very relevant to contemporary life, such as, you know, consumerism, strangely, like female adultery is still very taboo in 2014. And, you know, Flaubert, I think the classics, all the literary classics are timeless. You can have different interpretation as a filmmaker. I wish other filmmakers are going to continue making adaptation of this book just to see what the take is on the book. I think it's very exciting. What's interesting about Madame Bovary is that more than a character, she's embodies a piece of human condition. I mean, this is going to sound pretentious, but actually she does. I mean, the complexity of the character, her psychology, the fact that you can never really grasp who she is. She remains, she's a very, she's an eternal character because she has, you know, she has very early bipolarity, maybe something that in the 19th century wasn't very categorized as a medical condition, but there's something about her that is very enigmatic, and you can never fully grasp who she is, you know, and that's attracting, I think, for a filmmaker, because it's endless what you could say about her and the interpretations you can have about her psychology. Yes, I love British actors because I think, you know, they're so trained, the craft is very very strong, and they're all classically trained theater actors, and so when you work with Laura Carmichael or Luke Titterson or all the secondary actors, I mean Rhys Ifans, I forgot to mention Rhys, but they bring such craft and such joy and pleasure to tackle a classic, and I think that's why I was so drawn to make it in English and work with those type of actors. Well, it's really hard to, as a filmmaker, to dictate what you think the audience should feel because it's so subjective and personal, you know. But I think for me, it's if the audience can come away with the desire to read again the novel and to think about her, about the complexity of this character, and think, you know, just philosophically. It's the question that Camus was asking, is life worth living? It's a question of suicide. And if you live life, how do you live it to the fullest? How do you live your own life without always thinking that there is a better possible life, you know. So those philosophical questions about life and existence, and I think a work like Flaubert is bringing up all those questions. So for me as a filmmaker, I'm not interested in giving any answers, just raising questions.